Hi, my name is William Bellamy. I'm a principal escalation engineer supporting Microsoft Windows Azure. Today, I'll be demonstrating how to enable the remote desktop feature on a Windows Azure cloud service using Microsoft Visual Studio 2012. In this demonstration, I will show you how to enable remote desktop during the publishing process. Now let's switch to the Coho Winery solution open in Microsoft Visual Studio 2012. So if we open the service definition.csdef file, we can see a couple of things. First of all, there's one endpoint, which is HTTP for our web role, and there's one plugin, which is diagnostics. So remote desktop has not been enabled for this cloud solution. Now, if we'd like to publish the solution, we right-click on Coho Winery and choose Publish. And that will bring up the publishing wizard. Now, in this case, I've already filled out all of the information. So we go to the Previous tab for the settings, and there's a checkbox, Enable Remote Desktop for All Roles. Now, when you click on that, you get the remote desktop configuration. And you have really three pieces of information to enter: the username, password, and an expiration date. The username and password are very important because that is how you're going to prevent your instance from being hacked. So choose those username and passwords very wisely. It's not enough to have a password that has uppercase and lowercase. You have to have something that's not in a common dictionary that hackers are using. The next piece of information is about the certificates. So you have a choice. You can either leave the default, which is automatic, so it will automatically create your certificate, or you can create your own certificate using the csencrypt.exe utility file, or if you prefer PowerShell, there's also a commandlet, new-passwordencryptioncertificate. So now let's click on OK. So if you would like to publish up to Azure, you simply click on the Publish button at the bottom. In our case, we're going to click on Cancel, but we'll save the changes. And now, when we look at the service definition file, what do we see? Well, we see that the remote access has been added to both roles, both the web role and the worker role. And the worker role has an added plugin, which is Remote Forwarder. And if we look at the service configuration CFG file, what do we see? We see the username and the encrypted password. In addition, we see the certificate. So the certificate was used to encrypt the password, and that way nothing will go over the wire. This concludes the demonstration of enabling remote desktop in Microsoft Visual Studio 2012. In this video, I've demonstrated how to enable remote desktop to a Windows Azure cloud service during the publishing process. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing your great cloud services on Windows Azure.